They pool resources, they align on policy, and even present a united front to the media. So are they as fiercely independent as they say, or are they a quasi-minor party?
High deficits going out as far as the eye can see when we've got, you know, a significant $1 trillion worth of debt. Every dollar counts, and it should count.
Are you strength in numbers? I mean, you're not a party. You don't want to call yourself a party. And whenever I suggest that it, you know, looks and sounds like a party, none of the independents like that at all. Why not?
Well, the reality is, we're not a party. If you watch us, even just today, the divisions that we had today, we went in different directions and we spoke in different ways about different issues. We're actually quite disparate. The strength of the crossbench is in its increasing numbers. There's no doubt about that.
Well, at this point in time, it's not what my community asked of me.
Yeah, but, why not? Is that on the cards? Could you become a party? We have different spokespeople within the movement for different portfolios. You agree on things.
I don't know. What I do know is that I think the next decade in politics in Australia is going to be incredibly interesting.
We work well together. Now, the media can't have it both ways. On one hand, have an outcry about independents being elected and say it's going to be chaos, everyone's going to be doing their own thing. But then on the other hand, say if we work well together in a constructive, efficient way, that is a negative as well.
We have a lot of things in common, and some of that is values and a desire for long-term thinking, compassion, a sense of fairness. And I really like the rest of the crossbench who I've met. But ultimately, we are all accountable to our own communities. And that's really what is at the core of this movement.